Honduran citizen who was deported from the U.S. in 2013 was caught trying to sneak someone else's child across the U.S.-Mexico border while crossing a river into the country earlier this month. Emil Cargiza Reyes, 51, was charged with alien smuggling in federal court on May 10, according to Immigration and Customs Enforcement officials. Border Patrol agents spotted Cargiza Reyes wading through the Rio Grande River from Mexico into the U.S. near Hidalgo, Texas while carrying the infant on May 7. Immigration and Customs Enforcement officials said the infant was 6 months old. Cargiza Reyes initially claimed the baby was his son, according to ICE officials, but agents realized the child wasn't his after Cargiza Reyes presented a phony Honduran birth certificate for the baby at the Central Processing Center in McAllen, Texas. Cases like this demonstrate the real danger that exists to children in this disturbing new trend, HSI Acting Executive Associate Director Alyssa Erics said in a statement. While we have seen egregious cases of smugglers renting and recycling children, this case involving a 6-month-old infant is a new low, and an unprecedented level of child endangerment. HHS did not immediately respond to requests for comment on what will happen to the baby in this case. The Department's Office of Refugee Resettlement Division works with licensed foster care providers across the U.S. who provide homes to unaccompanied alien children, according to the office's website. Homeland Security investigations uncovered 95 instances of migrants lying about being parents to children that weren't theirs while crossing the border between mid-April and May 10, ICE officials said. Adult migrants involved in the alleged fraud can face federal prosecution for immigration crime, identity and benefit fraud, alien smuggling, human trafficking and child exploitation. Our goals remain twofold. 1. To protect children from being smuggled across the border by ensuring they are with their parents and not being used as pawns by individuals attempting to exploit immigration loopholes, Erics said. And 2. To identify and stop the criminal organizations that are generating false documents and supporting child smuggling.